Welcome everybody. In this vlog I'm going to show you how to install IBM RDI into the latest and the greatest version of Eclipse. Out of the box, Eclipse is a Java development environment. However, Eclipse can be molded into different shapes due to its plugin system and extension point architecture. Invented around 20 years ago, its architecture is still very strong. The plugin system enables third-party vendors like IBM and Remain Software to build on this platform, for example, to build RDI. The Eclipse IDE is constantly being improved. Many great programmers are working on it on a daily basis, making sure that it is super fast and stable. The current version is 4.16. However, RDI is running on Eclipse 4.6. RDI is running on an ancient, unstable and slow version of Eclipse, which is 10 versions behind. So in these topics, I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of RDI, make an update site that contains RDI artifacts, download the latest and the greatest Eclipse version, then install the RDI plugins into the new Eclipse and run. Have a new RDI running in a brand new latest version Eclipse. All right, so everybody can follow along with this blog because IBM is offering the RDI trial download. So you can go to any website and then Google RDI trial download and maybe add IBM. You get on the Rational Developer for I download site, and from here you can download RDI. If you have already installed RDI, then you can use that. And I'm currently running RDI version 9.6.0.8. So this is going to be a little bit technical, but if you follow along, you will be just fine. An update site, also known as a repository, is Eclipse lingo for a place where you can install software from. We will use this update site later in our new Eclipse version to install RDI. To create the update site, we first have to switch to the resource perspective. To do this, find the input box that says quick access. Then type resource and select perspectives resource. This will switch us to the resource perspective. In the resource perspective, you will find the Project Explorer. Click somewhere in this view and then press Ctrl N, which will pop up a select which will pop up the new wizard. Inside the new wizard, we will type update, which will bring us to the update site project. Then press next, and we give the project a name, for example, RDI update, and then we press finish. By default, a site.xml file will open in the editor area, and here we can add features. A feature is a grouping of plugins, and a plugin contains Java classes. You can compare a plugin with a service program, and you can compare a feature with a library. So what we want to do here is we want to select all the features that contain that start with, sorry, com IBM. So we scroll down, and finally we find all the com IBM features, which in this case are 172. Then we press OK, and the table in the site XML editor will be updated. So first we press Save, and then we press Build All. So when this fails because of an access error, you are probably running RDI from the program files directory. You can still do this, but then you have to start RDI as administrator. you can see that new content has been generated in this project. Now what we want to do is right-click on this RDI update folder or project, select properties, and then remember this location. So now it's time to download the latest version of Eclipse. To do that, we go to https://download.eclipse/downloads. Then in the latest downloads, we select 4.16, and then we scroll down and we will find the Eclipse variant for our platform. In this case, mine is Windows 64-bit. After Eclipse is downloaded, I copy it to a target location. In this case, I have a programs folder. Inside there, I have an Eclipse directory, but you can choose any directory. So I go into this zip file and rename this to Eclipse 4.16. And then I right click and say 7-zip, extract here. But any way of extracting will be fine. So I end up with this Eclipse 4.16 version, and inside here I have eclipse.exe, and I will start this. I will just use a workspace here in this directory. And a workspace is a place where your projects are stored, right? So it doesn't really matter what you choose, but I will just keep it in this location. All right, we are now in our brand new Eclipse. And what we're going to do next is we're going to do help install new software. First, what we want to do is we want to add our update site to Eclipse. We know it's local and it is in this folder, but you might have to search it again by going back into your RDI, right click on your project, do properties, and then select this directory. So I just choose this directory, select folder, and I give it a title. And I add this to my Eclipse installation. Then I can just tick this or open it up and see what is in there. And finally press next. Press next. Next. I accept the terms. Finish. We are almost there. We have to assert something. There's the certificate that we have to accept. And finally, we want to restart to activate the installed plugins. We get a new overview page, and inside here we can see that RDI has been installed. So when we close this and find the remote system perspective, remote system explorer, we have the remote system perspective here, and we say make a new connection to our IBM i. And then inside here, I want to work with members. Looking great. All right, so what you can do now is you can zip this directory that now also contains in the features the whole of RDI. You can zip this and give this to your coworker, and they can unzip it and then start it and work with RDI as well. All right, I hope this was interesting. So what we did is we installed the latest version of RDI. Then we made an update site inside RDI that contained the RDI artifacts. Then we downloaded the latest and the greatest version of Eclipse, unzipped it and ran it. Then we installed the RDI plugins into the new Eclipse. And finally, we have a new Eclipse with RDI installed. All right, I hope you enjoyed this. Thank you for watching. If you want to know more about this, know more about Eclipse, plugin development, or software change management, DevOps, please visit us here on these channels. And I will see you next time.